of dynamic stochastic general equilibrium model developed, and Calvo model is the most common way to model nominal rigidity in new Keynesian economics. And therefore, we say that complete nominal rigidity occurs when a price is fixed in nominal term for the relevant period of time. Calvo says that no, all complete nominal rigidity may not be there. There will be some hazard rate and there will be some survival rate. And hazard rate and survival rate both are taken into consideration to decide that whether the equilibrium will be obtained in the short run or even possibly in the long run through which method. And markets might not reach equilibrium in the short run because staggered prices will be a hurdle. Staggered prices will be a hurdle, and no change in the prices. No change in the prices is another survival rate. So if there is change in the general equilibrium, dynamic stochastic general equilibrium change, and economy falls down due to demand shock, then how can we recover? That depends upon the percentage of staggered prices and the percentage of not following the change in the price, that is survival rate and Calvo probability rate. Calvo probability is nothing but H. Calvo probability is nothing but H, nowadays it is said. So, in Calvo, a staggered contract model, there is a constant probability H. That firm can set a new price. The proportion of the firm can reset their prices in any period, while the remaining portion, 1 minus H, keep their prices constant. And therefore, it is very difficult to obtain equilibrium from disequilibrium macroeconomics in the short period. Thus, we conclude that in new Keynesian economics, Calvo, a staggered contract model and a staggered prices model plays an important role, especially when there is a dynamic, a stochastic general equilibrium analysis of macroeconomics. If there is shift from equilibrium to the case of not equilibrium, then how can it will be approached to the reset to the equilibrium? That depends upon all these facts. That's all. Thank you.